Fiber One. My name is Mr. Kuhn, and I'm gonna be your Fiber One teacher this year. We are covering 5 main units this semester: felt plush, embroidery, crochet, needle felting, and knitting. For the felt plush unit, we're gonna start out with the basics, just learning the simple stitches you need to make one of these, turning it inside out, stuffing it, and finishing it. And that's gonna give you a good idea of how this process works before we actually make anything that resembles something. Then we're gonna practice reading patterns by making a little banana plush. And then we're gonna finish this unit up by creating a 3-dimensional plush. I have patterns for dinosaurs, but you guys can kind of pick what you wanna make for that if you find something else that you prefer. For unit 2, we're gonna learn embroidery. And the first thing that we're gonna do is create a sample loop that goes over the 7 basic stitches that are really commonly used in embroidery. Once we have a good mastery of those, we're going to move on to actually creating a design for embroidery. And for that, the only stipulation is that you use at least 3 of the stitches that you did in your sampler. I'm gonna provide just hoops and canvas, but you have the option, if you would like, to embroider on a sweatshirt or on shoes or something else. Ultimately, you can start thinking sort of outside the box. I would love to make those things happen. Unit 3, we are learning crochet. Just start with the basics. You learn how to chain, how to single crochet, how to fasten off, and then weave in the ends. We'll create a little swatch so you understand how to do all of those things, and that's really the foundation of crochet in general. And then we're going to apply that by creating these festive pumpkins. And when we're doing that, that's gonna be right around Halloween, kind of fall, leaves are changing, it's gonna be very seasonal, so I'm really excited about the pumpkin project. They're just a lot of fun to make, they don't take a lot of time. For needle felting, we're gonna practice a little bit with the materials first, and then we're gonna create a 2-dimensional design, so there will be a day or two devoted to creating your design, getting some inspiration, and then actually doing that. To finish that unit, we are going to create a 3-dimensional creature. And then last but not least is our knitting unit. And this is one of my absolute favorite things to do in fiber arts, so I'm very excited to pass that along. Really, once you learn how to do it, it's very soothing. I know a lot of people maybe start and they don't feel that way at first, but when you get the basics, it is a lot of fun to do. So we'll start off learning how to cast on, do the knit stitch, cast off, all that good stuff. And we will do this by creating a small swatch of the garter stitch. Then we're gonna add purling to the repertoire by creating a swatch of what's called stockinette stitch. And then finally, we're gonna put all of those together by creating a seed stitch swatch. And the seed stitch, I think, is the prettiest stitch that I know how to make, although the fisherman's rib might be a close second. And we're gonna finish this unit off by choosing the stitch that you like the best and creating a tasteful scarf with that stitch. I budget time at the end of each semester for a final project. Basically, what you would do for this one is choose the unit that you like best. So felt plush, knitting, crochet, etc. And you create an independent project based on that. I just want for you guys to have a chance to delve more deeply into a unit that you really enjoyed and want to explore more of. So for this class, you are going to need a 5mm crochet hook, US size H, 5mm knitting needles, US size 8, and 3 skeins of whatever color yarn you would like to make a scarf out of. I chose this sort of off-white color. By the way, a skein is one of these babies, and you can just use regular worsted weight yarn. And it says this on the label right here. Now, that which I've compiled here on the left side is the stuff that you definitely need. And on the right side are a few extra things that might make your time in this class just a little bit more luxurious. First would be your own pair of scissors. Now the ones that I have in here have been touched by generations and generations of students. And although during the COVID year, they were sanitized into oblivion, you still might get a little bit yucked out thinking about that fact. So you may consider getting your own pair. Next would be a tapestry needle and an embroidery needle. I'm gonna be distributing these, but there's a chance that you might want your own. And this would really just come into play with the embroidery project. You maybe want a needle that has a slightly larger eye or a slightly smaller eye, but that is not too much of a biggie, honestly. Finally, in the optional category is a work bag. I have this one that I got from Walmart, and this is what I carry around my knitting with. At the time of this video, I've been working on a sweater, so here is a sleeve tucked away in the bag that I've been gradually working on. The first category is what's definitely required, and the second category is if you really want to get into it. And if you guys are unable to get any of the required materials, just let me know and I will work something out for you. So that's all, and I'm extremely excited to meet you guys and looking forward to a great semester.
Uh-huh, honey.
Jerome's in the house, watch your mouth. Jerome's in the house, watch your mouth. Your mouth, your mouth. Bam. Your mouth.